Okay, dear students, welcome to physics PU class. As we have discussed in the previous class, the photoelectric Einstein photoelectric equation, and the explanation for the experimental results of the photoelectric effect based on the Einstein photoelectric equation. Now let us solve here some numericals based on the Einstein photoelectric equation. So first let us write here the Einstein photoelectric equation. So Einstein photoelectric equation is equal to what? It is equal to what? The energy of incident photon is equal to E is equal to what? Work function plus kinetic energy of the photoelectrons. Right? This is the equation. Now energy of the incident photon is equal to h nu, and phi naught is the work function, h nu naught, and this is kinetic energy is half m v square. And in terms of wavelength you can write, because you all know that nu is equal to c by lambda. Therefore, h nu you can written as what? C by lambda. And here h nu naught can written as what? C by lambda naught. Then plus half m v square. Right? The kinetic energy of the photoelectrons. Now the problem what we have to solve here. Calculate the photoelectric work function. Work function we have to calculate here. What is work function? The minimum amount of energy required to liberate the electrons from the metal surface. That is called as the work function. So here the hc by lambda naught or h nu naught. This we have to calculate here. So in the first case, you have to calculate the work function of the metal when the threshold frequency of the metal is 5.8 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. And then you have to calculate the threshold wavelength. You have to calculate what? The work function when the threshold wavelength is 520 nanometer. So what are the given data? The numerical is two values are given. Let us solve here one by one. Solution for A. When the threshold frequency is given, how to calculate the work function? So you have to use what? H nu naught. So work function pi naught is equal to work function pi naught is equal to H nu naught. Here nu naught is given, that is 5.8 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. Right? Now pi naught is equal to, the h value is, h is Planck's constant, you know, 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34, into mu naught is the threshold frequency, 5.8 into 10 to the power 40. Right? Now this value we will get in terms of joule. Right? Here the work function we will get in terms of joule. So first let us calculate here in terms of joule, then you can calculate it in terms of electron volt. So to calculate the work function, multiply these two, 6.626 into 5.8 is 38.43 into minus 34 plus 14, it is 10 to the power minus 20. So here the energy is represented in joule. Now let us convert this energy joule in terms of electron volt. So one electron volt is in terms of joule is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule, or 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule is equal to 1 electron volt. So if 38.43 into 10 to the power minus 20 joule energy is the work function, then how to represent it in terms of electron volt, right? So that is what we can represent here. You have to divide it by what? 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Right? If you divide it by the value of E, it will be converted in terms of electron volt. Right? What is the value of E then? Pi naught is equal to 38.43 into 10 to the power minus 20 divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. And this value is equal to 38.43 divided by 1.6 value is 24.01, and this is minus 20 and this is minus 10. Minus 90 get cancelled here, or 10 to the power minus 1 is remaining. Then dividing by 10, 24.01 divided by 10, it is equal to 2.4 electron volt. So this is the required answer. So the work function of the metal is equal to what here? 2.4 electron volt. When the frequency is given, the work function is calculated in this way. Alright, when the frequency is given, the short frequency, we have to calculate the work function in this way. H mu naught, put the value of mu naught, multiply, we will get in terms of joule, divided by E, that will be converted in terms of electron volt. Now, the next one, let us calculate here, that is about the threshold wavelength. So, that time you have to use which formula here? This is wavelength is given here, right? This is the threshold wavelength is given. So that time work function, how it is calculated? Hc divided by lambda naught. Now let us do B. So work function, when the threshold wavelength is given, right? Hc by lambda naught. So again it is in joules, to convert it divided by E, charge of the electron lambda. So pi naught is equal to 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34. C is the velocity of light, 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, right? Then divided by charge of the electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 lambda naught, threshold wavelength 520 nanometer. 520 into 10 to the power minus 9 nanometers. 9. Then, so all the values are in SI unit. So directly you can calculate here by multiplying these two and multiplying these two, divide the numerator and denominator and solve the powers, will get the same answer, that is equal to 2.4 electron. Because the metal is same, so the work function remains the same. Right? So in this way, we have to solve here the numerical calculation of the work function. So the next problem, calculate the energy in electron volt. Calculate the energy in electron volt for a photon of wavelength 430 nanometer. Right? And the second one is the photon of frequency 4.2 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. First one, so we know that the energy of a photon is given by the equation E is equal to h nu. The first point what we have given, photon of wavelength is given. We have to calculate the energy of photon in terms of electron volt here, right? And you know that nu is equal to C by lambda. Nu is equal to what? C by lambda. But to convert it in terms of electron volt divided by the electronic charge, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So to convert it in terms of electron volt, I divide here by the electronic charge, and the value of H is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34, and the value of C is velocity of light, 3 into 10 to the power 8, and divided by the electronic charge 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 into the value of lambda is given 430 nanometer 430
meter, right? So this 430 into 10 to the power minus 9. So if you solve this with a simplification, you will get final answer is 2.89 electron volt. So simplify this, you will get 2.89 electron volt. So this is the first answer, the photon of wavelength 430 nanometer, and its energy in electron volt is calculated by using the formula h nu, but nu is equal to c by lambda in terms of electron volt divided by the electronic charge. And the second one, a photon of frequency is given. Frequency means nu is given, E is equal to h nu. So in terms of electron volt divided by E. So it is equal to 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 into the value of frequency is 4.2 into 10 to the power 14 hertz divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So for this we will get the answer 1.74 electron volt. So after simplification you will get this answer. The energy of the photon of frequency 4.2 into 10 to the power 14 hertz, its energy is 1.74 electron volt. The photon of wavelength 430 nanometer, its energy is given by 2.89 electron volt. So in this way you have to calculate the energy for a given wavelength and for a given frequency. So note down these points. Okay, now let us take one more problem here. The threshold frequency of a certain metal is 3.3 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. The threshold frequency of a certain metal is 3.3 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. If the light of frequency 8.2 into 10 to the power 14 hertz is incident on a metal, calculate the stopping potential for the photoelectric emission. Stopping potential or the cutoff voltage we have to calculate here, right? So what are the two points we have, the values they have given here? The given data is what here? The threshold frequency nu naught is given. We know that the photoelectric equation, Einstein photoelectric equation, what we write here, h nu is equal to h nu naught or plus kinetic energy, k max, right? What we write here, the kinetic energy of the ejected electrons, maximum kinetic energy, right? Or this is equal to what, h nu plus pi naught, work function plus kinetic energy. So stopping potential, what is the formula for stopping potential here? So kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy is equal to E into V naught. So V naught we have to calculate here. V naught we have to calculate. This is the stopping potential we have to calculate. The maximum kinetic energy is equal to E into V naught, where V naught is the stopping potential. Right. So to calculate this, first we have to calculate the energy of the incident photon in terms of electron volt and the work function in terms of electron volt, then we can calculate what the stopping potential here. So the first point here, the energy of the incident photon, is equal to what here, h nu naught is given, the threshold frequency 3.3 into 10 to the power 14 hertz, and nu is equal to energy of the frequency of the incident photon. Frequency of the incident photon nu is equal to 8.2 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. So now the frequency of the, using the frequency of the incident photon, we can calculate the energy here. So energy E is equal to h nu divided by E in terms of electron volt. Now it becomes 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34. Nu is 8.2 into 10 to the power 14 hertz divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So this you will get the energy of the incident photon in terms of electron volt 3.39 electron volt. Simplify this, you will get this value. Next, the work function. Work function is equal to what here? Work function is equal to H mu naught divided by E. H mu naught divided by E. So this is equal to 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34. So frequency of the incident photon is 3.3 into 10 to the power 14 hertz divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So for this you will get the value 1.37 electron volt. So now then, what is kinetic energy? We have to calculate here. So kinetic energy is equal to what then? The difference between the energy of the incident photon and the work function. So it is equal to h nu minus pi naught. So that is equal to what? H nu minus pi naught. Now, what is the value of h nu here? That is the energy of the incident photon. E we have got here. We can write it as E. Energy of the incident photon. So E is equal to what we have got here in terms of electron volt. 3.39 minus pi naught is 1.37. So 3.39 minus 1.37, you will get 2.02 electron volt. So this is the kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy of the ejected electron. Now, so stopping potential, the relation between stopping potential and the kinetic energy is equal to what? So K max kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy is equal to E into V naught. So that, what is the kinetic energy we have got now? 2.02 electron volt, right? 2.02 electron volt, and it is equal to what? E into V naught, right? E into V naught. So this E and E get cancelled here, the electronic charge, therefore stopping potential V naught is equal to 2.02 volt. So that is equal to what? 2.02 volt. So here, kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy of the ejected electrons, what we have got here? 2.02 electron volt, right? But the relation is what? Maximum kinetic energy is equal to E into V naught, where V naught is the stopping potential. Now, therefore, 2.02 electron volt is equal to E into V naught, where V naught is the stopping potential. Stopping potential means what? The potential energy required to stop the electrons, right? Now, this E and E get cancelled here. Then, V naught is equal to 2.02 volt. So, this is the stopping potential for a photoelectric emission of a certain metal, what they have given. The energy of the incident photon is 3.39 electron volt and work function is 1.37 electron volt, and the kinetic energy of the ejected electron is this one and the stopping potential is this one. So you have to remember this formula here, and this formula, that is photoelectric, Einstein photoelectric equation. From that only we have to solve all the numericals based on the what? The photoelectric emission here. Now let us look some numericals based on what? The dual nature of radiation and matter. So in the previous class we have discussed about the Einstein photoelectric equation and experimental results, explanation of the experimental results based on the Einstein photoelectric equation. Now the numericals also based on the photoelectric equation here, right? Which one is what? E is equal to pi naught plus kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy of the ejected electrons. So it is equal to h nu naught and it is half 1v square or maximum velocity of the ejected electrons, right? Now the problem is a photon of frequency 5.2 into 10 to the power 14 hertz is incident on the metal surface of threshold frequency. So the frequency of the incident photon is given and the threshold frequency is given. Calculate the energy of the incident photon, photoelectric work function, kinetic energy of the maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectrons and the maximum velocity of the electrons. We have to calculate. Now the solution, the first one, we have to calculate the energy of the incident photon. So it is E is equal to h nu. So to convert it in terms of electron volt, you have to divide it by the electronic charge E. So it is equal to 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 into nu is given 5.2 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. It is the frequency of the incident photon divided by distance to the power 14 divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So after simplification, you will get the answer 2.15 electron volt. After simplification you will get. Now the second one, the photoelectric work function pi naught is equal to h nu naught. So second one, pi naught is equal to h nu naught divided by E in terms of electron volt. The energy is expressed in terms of electron volt. Now again 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 and the frequency of the threshold frequency 4.4 into 10 to the power 40 divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 90. So after simplification we will get the work function 1.82 electron volt. It is 1.82 electron volt after simplification we will get. Next, the third one, the maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectrons. So maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectron just can be calculated by this equation only. So K max kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy of the ejected electrons or photoelectrons is equal to E minus pi naught. The value of energy of incident photon is 2.15 electron volt minus 1.82 electron volt. So you will get the difference is 0.33 electron volt. So 0.33 electron volt. So this is the kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectron. So if you want to convert it in terms of joule, multiply 0.33 into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Multiplying it by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, you will get the energy in terms of joule. 0.528 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. So this is the kinetic energy. This is the kinetic energy in terms of what it is? Joules. So this is the energy of the incident photon. This is the energy of, it is the work function of the metal, and the maximum kinetic energy of the ejected electron in terms of joule, and this is in terms of 0.33 volt in terms of electron volt. Now the fourth one we have to calculate here about the maximum velocity of the ejected electrons or the photoelectrons. So maximum velocity of the ejected electrons, that can be calculated here. The maximum velocity of the photoelectrons from the kinetic energy equation we can calculate. Kinetic energy is equal to half m v max square. So kinetic energy is equal to half maximum velocity of the electrons square, right? Now we want the velocity here. So velocity is equal to what? V square is equal to 2 times of kinetic energy divided by m.
Right? 2 times of kinetic energy divided by m, where m is the mass of the electron.
Right? Therefore, V is equal to square root of 2 into kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy of the electrons, we are using in terms of Joule. Right? Divided by mass of the electron, it is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. Right? Now, the kinetic energy is what here?
Kinetic energy is equal to what we have calculated here, 0.528 into 10 to the power minus 90.
So V is equal to 2 into kinetic energy, 0.528 into 10 to the power minus 90 divided by mass of the electron. That is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 30. So after simplification and taking the square root,
you will get the answer 3.4
into 10 to the power 5 meter per second. So this is the maximum velocity of, so this mass is under the square root, right? This mass is under the square root.
Now the velocity of the photoelectrons with which they have emitted is, the maximum velocity of the photoelectrons is 3.4 into 10 to the power 5 meter per second. So you can simplify this square root, you will get this answer. Right? So in this problem, what we have calculated here, the first one, we have calculated the first thing, the first point we have calculated, the energy of the incident photon, E is equal to h nu divided by E, E is equal to h nu divided by E, h nu is the incident photon, energy of incident photon divided by E, because of what? To convert it in terms of electron volt. So in this way, work function we have calculated, that is 1.82 electron volt. Then difference between the energy of incident photon and work function, you will get the kinetic energy of the maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectrons. Now the maximum velocity of the electrons can be calculated by the kinetic energy equation. The kinetic energy is equal to half m v square. Therefore, v square is equal to 2 times of kinetic energy divided by m. So by taking the square root and by putting the values, you will get the final answer. Vmax is equal to 3.4 into 10 to the power 5 meter per second. So in this way, you have to solve the numericals based on what? The Einstein photoelectric equation.
Problem is like this. The work function of the cesium metal is 2.14 electron volt. The work function of cesium metal. Photoelectric effect means what? The process of emission of, phenomenon of emission of electrons from the surface of a metal when a light of suitable frequency incident on it is called the photoelectric effect. The work function of the cesium metal is 2.14 electron volt. When a light of frequency 6 into 10 to the power 14 hertz is incident on the metal surface, then, so this is the frequency of the incident radiation, this is the frequency of incident radiation, the photo emission of electrons takes place, calculate or find the energy of the incident photons, this is the first one we have to calculate, and the second one, the maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectrons. So these two points we have to calculate here. So the first point, what they are given? Pi naught. Work function is given, that is 2.14 electron volt. And second one, the frequency of incident radiation is given. Nu is equal to 6 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. These two points are given.
Next, work function is equal to what? The work function is equal to, the first you can write the Einstein photoelectric equation,
h nu is equal to h nu naught plus kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electrons. Right, this is h nu, this is pi naught, work function, then this is kinetic energy. Maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electrons.
Now, first one, what you can calculate here? The
the energy of the incident photons, and second one, the maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectrons. Right? So then nu is given. So how we can calculate the energy of the incident photon? H nu. So E is equal to H nu, energy of the incident photon. E is equal to Planck's constant, 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34. Nu is given. Nu is given, that is 6 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. Now you multiply these two, you will get the answer in terms of joules. In terms of joules, 3.975 into 10 to the power minus 19 you will get. It is in terms of joule. To convert it in terms of electron volt, divide it by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So in terms of electron volt, E is equal to 3.975 into 10 to the power minus 19 divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So after this, what you will get? E is equal to energy of the incident photon is equal to 2.48 electron volt. So this is the energy of the incident photon in terms of electron. So just they have given the frequency of incident radiation. Frequency of incident radiation, if you multiply it with the Planck's constant, you will get the energy of the incident photon. If you divide it by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, you will get in terms of electron volt. So this is the simple point here. Next one, the maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectron. So how can calculate here the maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectrons, right? So according to photoelectric equation, one can write kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy is equal to what? The equation is, photoelectric equation, H nu minus H nu or H nu minus pi. So H nu is equal to what here? 2.48 minus, what is pi naught is 2.14. So if you take the difference, you will get around kinetic energy, maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electrons, 2.48 minus 2.14, right? It is equal to what? You will get the answer 0.34 electron volt. So this is the maximum kinetic energy of the liberated electrons. Again, if you want to convert it in terms of joules, what we can do here? Multiply electron to volt, multiply it by 1.6. So kinetic energy max is equal to 0.34. So multiplication is because in terms of electron volt, 0.34 into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So then you will get 0.55 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. So this is kinetic energy in terms of joules. This is in terms of electron. So this is a simple problem. So every problem is based on the what? Einstein photoelectric equation here. Based on the Einstein photoelectric equation. You have to remember the three things here. One is the kinetic energy expression and the energy of the incident photon and the work function. So now let us take the one more problem.